Morning, Classroom 1A. It's time for meeting. Let's go over the details of our day. Yesterday was what? What day was yesterday? Yesterday was Thursday. So if yesterday was Thursday, then today is what? If yesterday was Thursday, then today is Friday. Yeah, today is Friday. Which means it's almost the weekend. So if yesterday was Thursday and today is Friday, then tomorrow will be what? If yesterday was Thursday and today is Friday, then tomorrow will be Saturday. Yeah, tomorrow is Saturday, which means it's the weekend. And remember, it's a special weekend because we're going into a break for Thanksgiving. So today is the last day with new videos and a Zoom meeting until Tuesday, December 1st. Yeah, so this is our last one of November. All right, so today is Friday. The month again is November. What number? When there is a 2 and a 0 next to each other in this order, that makes the number 20 or 20th. So today is Friday, November 20th, and the year is 2020. So today's date is 11/20/2020. What season are we in? It's fall. Yeah, this season is fall. And it actually feels like fall this week, which is so nice. So then what is the weather like outside today? You can look outside your windows. Miss Jessica's going to look outside her windows. Remember, you might have to stand up to look out your windows. But Miss Jessica is sitting at her desk, so she's able to just kind of look both ways. When I look outside my windows, I see that it's sunny, but also cloudy. So we probably call that partly sunny or partly cloudy. I think it's going to be cool again today. It's exciting. All right, let's go over our classroom rules. Be respectful of yourself and others. Remember, we need to respect all people, and that includes yourself because you're a person. We respect people's choices, differences, ability levels, personal space, personal property, time. Yeah, we need to respect all aspects of all people. One great way to show respect is to keep hands, feet, and objects to yourself. You need to be safe with your body and with the objects around you. Even if you're upset, you need to make good choices. This one can be a challenge right now to understand. Follow the directions of all your teachers. I say this one can be a challenge because you're not working with Miss Jessica or your staff or other teachers regularly in person right now. But there's still people in your life that you need to listen and follow their directions. Parents, care providers, respite workers, any support staff you may have, family members. They ask you to do the things they ask you to do to keep you safe. Always use nice words. We need to make good choices and be appropriate with our language and our tone of voice, even if we're upset. People aren't going to want to listen to us if we're yelling at them or using inappropriate language. Always do your best. Yes, always do your best. Remember, we do the best we can with what we have each day, and your best can look different from day to day and from situation to situation. Your best might look different from someone else's best, and that's okay too. As long as you are trying your best, that's all that matters. Alrighty, this is our Communication Bill of Rights. We're adults and we have rights, and 15 of those rights pertain to our communication, how we communicate with others and how they communicate with us. Each day, we've done 3 because there's 15. So Monday we did 3, Tuesday we did 3, Wednesday we did 3, Thursday we did 3, and now we're going to do the last 3. Okay. I have the right to be heard and answered, even if I can't have what I want. You have requests. You have things that you ask for. And you have a right to be heard and answered when it comes to those requests. But sometimes we have to cope, because sometimes that answer is no. Things, people, places, they may not be available. You have the right to ask for them, but sometimes that answer might be no. And we have to cope with that. I have the right to know about the people in my life and everything happening to me. You're a person, and you have a right to know about what's going on in your life and everything that could be happening to you and the people that are around you too. You have a right to know what's going on. And that goes along with the right to be talked to and not about. Yeah, you have a right to those things. I have the right to be taught how to communicate and have what I need. Everyone communicates differently. Some of us talk, like Miss Jessica. Some of us use sign language. Others use devices or a communication book. No matter how you communicate with others, you have a right to what you need for that communication. Yeah, and to be taught how to use it appropriately. Because your voice matters, and what you think and all the things, everything that you have to say, it matters. It's important for you to have a way to communicate. So we know what's going on. And your thoughts and your feelings. All right. And lastly, how are we feeling today? Are you hungry? Do you have a headache? Are you cold? Are you tired? Are you hot? Are you confused? Are you sick? Are you sad? Are you happy? Are you bored? Are you frustrated? Or are you thirsty? You can point or you can tell somebody. If there's a way you're feeling that's not listed, you can tell somebody that as well. Good job. All right. How is Miss Jessica feeling today? I'm just so boring this week. It's the same. Surprise, surprise. I'm a little tired today. It's true. I'm tired. I think it's probably like the change in weather. It's been a pretty long week. So that means maybe during break, I need to make sure I'm resting. Yeah, taking a break. All right. As I have been for the last eight and a half months, I'm a little sad. I'm sad. It's true. I'm sad because I miss all of you so very, very much. And usually today we would be celebrating by having our feast that we've done every single year for as long as I can remember. Even when Ms. Jessica was an aide, when she was some of your guys' age, when she worked here, we did the feast every year before Thanksgiving. So it's really, really hard to have today not be feast day. Yeah, and that makes me sad because it's a memory that we're missing out on making together. And that when we come back from this break, it'll be December already. And that's a month where we do so many fun things usually in school. And remember, it's okay to say you're sad about something. It's okay to feel sad and to talk about those feelings. But you have to cope with them because I have to keep going on even though it makes me sad. But even though I'm tired and I'm sad because I miss you and I miss the things that I feel like we should be doing together, when I think about all of you, home, happy, healthy, safe, well taken care of, and the fact that hopefully someday soon we will be back together and making all sorts of new memories, and you know, hopefully next year's feast will be even bigger, even bigger and better because we missed this year's, and this year will just be a memory. That makes me really, really happy. It's true. Thinking about all of you and our future together, thinking about all the memories we will make when we're back in this classroom working so hard, that makes me happy. It's true. Alrighty, and with that, meeting is all done. Please remember that today we have our 10 o'clock Zoom meeting, and that will be the last meeting until December 1st. I'm also going to do a reading video today, and so this video and the reading video will also be the last new ones posted until December 1st, which is a Tuesday. Yeah. All right. I hope you have a good day today, friends. A beautiful Friday. A good break. A happy Thanksgiving. And I will see you in my videos on Tuesday, December 1st. Bye, friends.